Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm gonna walk you through how the Jedi build set up. Bear with me, I haven't made many build videos, so this is one of my first. I probably made a few, but I didn't voice over them, so. This is 1.8 now, but when I made this was 1.7. But it transfers over really good. So for my backpack, I have crit hit damage with a firearm soul, bleed resistance. There's gonna be a lot of predators in 1.8, so I figured the bleed resistance will come in handy. I know it ignores it, but they may patch that or change it in the future because it seems a little overpowered right now. So I'm hoping that comes in handy later. For my gloves, most people will go with the 12% marksman rifle damage, but as a Deadeye, you're already getting 2-shot kills, maybe 3 shots if they have a lot of toughness. If they have an overheal, which I doubt you'll ever have to do 4 shots with a Deadeye, but yeah, I feel like marksman rifle damage isn't needed really. You do have the booster shot, so that helps. Of course, I'm gonna go crit hit damage. That goes to your base stats as a Deadeye. Enemy armor damage, it helps with the mitigation. It's more useful if you're playing PvE, but I didn't design this build for PvE. It's more for PvP, so. I figure any bit of damage stat I could get helps. Reload speed. So I'm using the MP7 as my secondary. So if I get rushed, I could pull out the MP7, unload a round. Hopefully the first round will kill them, but sometimes you miss a few shots since it shoots so fast. So I'll be able to hastily reload my gun and lay into them a second round. And I'm gonna explain to you why I'm gonna get that second round. It's kind of trolly. But it works so well. I'm not gonna attach gameplay footage to this video, but if you just scroll, you'll be able to find I have a gameplay where I went 11-0 on skirmish. This is with randoms, so I'm not playing with a team in any of my last damn matches, or except if I list them in the title, like if I'm playing with Cody or someone I know, or but yeah, skirmish I've only ever played solo so far. So. You see that? You're just gonna roll, of course, for the highest stats you can get in firearms on everything for your holster, but firearms is the main shit you need. For the gloves, crit hit damage, of course. Damage to elites is a bonus for if you play PvE a lot. Firearms roll, also. It's a Deadeye, you're doing everything firearms. Mask, enemy armor damage. You don't need crit hit chance. You're going to be fighting mostly with your sniper rifle, so you automatically crit if you're in cover, and if you're Deadeye, you're probably shooting from cover. So, crit hit chance might help for the MP7, but really, it's not that necessary. I'd rather go with the 8% enemy armor damage than 4% crit chance for the MP7 alone, you know? Burn resistance, there's turrets. Shit is crazy. Firearm assault. The 6-piece is, I think, is better for PvE, and I think it's better. If you're not using a bolt action rifle, if you're using a regular gun that shoots faster, like the SOCOM or the police MK or the SVD, that'll work well because you're behind cover, you could keep picking shots. With Deadeye, I just don't feel it's too situational, so I use Reckless Vest. So I could 2-shot, the extra 8% comes in handy. Now the thing is, when someone runs up on you, you're gonna be taking actually 10% damage. I'm gonna show you how to get past that also. I rolled health, enemy armor damage. You kind of want to get all the health you could get because a lot of people rush you if they see you're a Deadeye, and you weren't reckless, so it's gonna be hard for you if they rush. Ammo capacity. I feel like that's the best minor attribute. No one really needs kill XP if you're max level. Health and firearms are all my mods. Now I did mess up and I have pulse critical hit chance, but I don't have a pulse. So basically I'm thinking it works if I shoot them with the MP7 in the head, it'll pulse them and I get the extra damage. But I'm probably gonna switch it out for first aid self heal. Or seeker mine explosive radius. But that's a funny thing. Why do I have a seeker mine, not inverse, on this build? So how I look at it. When you're a Deadeye, someone sees you with a sniper rifle, you're behind cover. The first thought is they're gonna zigzag and rush you. So it's gonna be really hard to land your sniper rifle shot or someone is running towards you and zigzagging. Well, at least for me, because I'm not the best shot. But what the airburst does, you don't have to aim it, you just let it go. The airburst is going to hit them. It's not going to do any damage. I have no skill power. But what it is going to do is it's going to burn them for 5 or 6 seconds. So you have 10k firearms, you're Deadeye. Your secondary is a MP7. Someone that rushed you is now standing in front of you, burning for 5 seconds, unable to shoot. Or it forces the medkit. Either way, it works for you. So you just pull out your MP7 and you melt them, and they can't fight back because they're on fire. It works amazing. Now, another thing is when you're behind cover. Usually, when you're sniping, you're looking forward to the sides, but people can sneak up behind you pretty good. When you have the seeker mine out and you're sitting behind cover just waiting, you can drop the seeker mine, and if someone sneaks up on you, it whistles, and it's gonna hit them. They're gonna burn. Turn around. You melt them with the MP7. I have gameplay posted on my page. You can just look through it, and it works incredibly well. It's basically crowd control. Even if you have to retreat, you just send the airburst, slows them down. You get to your team, you run around corner, whatever you gotta do to get away. Booster shot is kind of a given. I have no cooldown, so I'm just using the booster shot for damage. It doesn't really heal me either. The airburst. So the cooldown on the airburst is 31 seconds, 32 seconds. You're not gonna be able to use this twice. So basically, sometimes when someone runs up in you and you let go of the airburst, you're gonna wanna dive back. Because if the fire touches you, it's gonna nerf your whole advantage. If you start burning, they're burning, you lost your advantage. You want them to burn, you wanna be in the clear, you wanna pull out your MP7 and melt them with 10k firearms and reckless before they can respond. So let's go into the stats. Where are the stats? You can tell I'm really new at this. So firearms 9,700. That's good enough. Like I said, you're going for a two-shot kill, maybe three shots, so it works. It's almost 10k. I don't think 10k will make that much of a difference. Like if you're a two-shot and I were 10k firearms instead of 9,700, 9,800, I'd still be a two-shot. Crit chance, well, there's the MP7, so crit damage 101. That's pretty good. Let's go to the sniper. So that's where we're gunning for. I'll go over the talents after. I'm sorry, I completely just overlooked that. So crit hit damage on the sniper rifle is 174. Headshot damage is 155, but it doesn't need to be max because you're Deadeye. I'm probably gonna optimize it so if I just shoot out of cover and hit ahead, I get the damage buff, but it's not that important right now. So I did go for enemy armor damage. Now I know armor isn't a huge thing, but the mitigation helps a bit. You wanna be a 2-3, 2-shot kill, but if they force 3 shots, hey. Oh, talents. On the MP7, I have responsive. If when they rush you, they're gonna be real close. Deadly, it's basic for SMGs. And unforgiving, you don't have good heal, so the chances are if they shoot you as they're running towards you, you're in 2 bars or in your last bar, you'll get that much more power. Rate of fire, I think, is really important on the MP7. It shoots fast enough, but any extra little 5% bonus really pumps 44 bullets into them, and you have 5 seconds, so you want to get as much damage to them as possible. I'm going with the crit hit chance scope. I feel like the extra damage is nerfed by the extra chance. Like if you're not hitting as many crits, you're not getting that extra damage as often. I'd rather hit more crits than have a tiny bit of extra damage. Alright, so you can see more crit chance on my MP7. Great damage on the underbarrel, because what else would you use? You only stability on the SMG. So prepared, deadly, and elevated. Elevated, I'm not so sure about. Like a lot of times when you're shooting with a sniper rifle, you're not above someone, but at the same time, it's multiplicative, so it does the most damage. So I'm not one that would stand on top of a gun and shoot at someone. I think that's really stupid. Like they're gonna see you, you're in open. But hey, let's say you have like a ledge and you can look down on someone, you're gonna get that much damage extra. But you're still a 2 to 3 shot kill. We're aiming at 2-shot, but with the toughness buff, You may be a three shot, it's not that fun, but hey. Yeah, that's the build. Talented, you don't really need on this. I use this for this character for most of my builds, so it's just there. But sustain and predatory come in handy. You just gun butt them as you run. You gun butt them, they die, you run away, you're getting healed. Let's say you're moving cover to cover. You gun butt them, you run to cover, you're getting healed while you're getting cover to pick off the next person with your dead eye. And am I missing anything? Oh, secondary talent, sorry. So let's go to that. I think this is basic for everyone, like this survivability. You just make it during low health to increase damage resistance. If you're about to die, you're gonna use a make it. 20% damage resistance helps. We're also using reach low health to reduce active. This is maybe you get lucky, you get to use a second air burst. If you're about to die, like let's say they got you, you're running away, you run around a car, stall a few seconds, now you can use air burst again, it may be helpful. I don't use this as much as I should, I'm just not used to running cover to cover, but I've looked at a lot of videos, and a lot of videos are using this, and I think it's extremely viable for a sniper, I just need to get into the habit of using it more. This, I think, is cool. I'm not running a pulse, I'm running the seeker mine. So if I want to pulse someone, I just shoot them in the head, which is not extremely hard. If I'm looking at them from a scope and they're not moving, I'm gonna get that shot. If they're close and they are moving, I have the MP7, I could just scroll up, hit them in the head a little, and come back to the body and get that extra pulse damage. I feel like I'm missing something. Well, I think that's about it. Can't figure out what I'm missing. Ooh, I have cash. Yeah. Alright, well, guess that's the end of the video. If you like enjoy the build, I know I'm not the best at videos right now. I'll get used to it, I'll keep practicing. But if you enjoyed the build, leave a like, maybe sub. More build videos coming soon. The GE event for the first one of 1.8 is coming tomorrow. It's gonna include Nomad, Predator's Mark, D3, and Banshee. So I'm gonna be experimenting so much with those builds. And I know people are gonna get at you for the Seeker Mine Airburst. I have a Last Stand match, you should check it out. It's Deadeye with a bit of crowd control, that's what it's titled, you'll find it on my page. There's a shield dude that keeps trying to, I don't know if he's trolling me. you know how you kill someone once, they get tunnel vision and they want to keep coming for you? He kept coming for me, it didn't work out well for him. Like I think I killed him like 5 times. I'm not really sure. And I wasn't going after him. I was behind cover, he's looking for the sniper, he kept coming up on me. And the air burst kept screwing him over. I think he got me once, maybe twice, I'm not sure, but it was a good match. Well, have a good night and happy holidays. I probably need to make a video before the end of the holidays, but I don't know, I feel like I should say it. Well, take care everyone.